Afternoon. I hope and I believe all of you are doing well. Am I audible and visible? Am I audible and visible to everyone, guys? Okay, so I can see the josh is very very high with everyone. So it has been after a long long time कि हमने जो quiz की link डाली है, the maximum limit has been reached and then we had to post a new link. And in that also approximately more than like 200 students have given the quiz. So we've had a whooping number of approximately 750 students giving the today's quiz. Right, so I'm so glad to see this all. But सिर्फ one request, like keep this जोश high जितना अभी है day one. I know that this is a new timetable. Everyone is excited, has all the जोश to finish the daily targets. So please maintain this consistency. I was just reading, watching something अभी, and I was reading that video post. ठीक है, मैं वापस करके देखती हूँ. अभी ठीक है? इज इट ओके नाउ? इज इट ओके नाउ? आई थिंक दिस शुड बी ओके नाउ. द वीडियो शुड बी बेटर नाउ. देख लो एक बार. ओके या सो वी हैड अ गुड नंबर. सो आई वॉज टेलिंग यू अबाउट कंसिस्टेंसी. यू नो वाई वाई डू वी फेस दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ नॉट बींग कंसिस्टेंट, लाइक बी इट स्टार्टिंग विथ स्टडीज और मेंटेनिंग दैट रिदम, और बी इट एक्सरसाइज, बी इट एनी न्यू हैबिट दैट वी आर फॉर्मिंग. इट इज बेसिकली लाइक इफ इट इज अलाइनिंग विथ आर गोल. ओके, इफ इट इज अलाइनिंग विथ द गोल दैट इज ऑफ इंटरेस्ट टू अस. यू नो, सो अगर ये हमारा खुद का गोल है विच इज ऑफ आर इंटरेस्ट, विच इज वी आर वॉट पैशनेट अबाउट. यू नो, लेट्स से समन हु इज नॉट वेरी पैशनेट अबाउट बिल्डिंग अ गुड बॉडी और हैविंग अ गुड हेल्थ, उसके लिए एक्सरसाइज एक दो दिन करेंगे, किसी के बोलने पे करेंगे, बट देन ही और शी विल नॉट कंटिन्यू विद द एक्सरसाइज बिकॉज दैट पर्सन इज नॉट इंटरनली मोटिवेटेड यू नो टू डू द एक्सरसाइज. बट वेन यू हैव दैट गोल कि आई एम डूइंग दिस एक्सरसाइज सो दैट आई कैन रन दिस पर्टिकुलर मैराथन और आई कैन रन दिस 400 मीटर्स, दिस थिंग इन 5 मिनट्स और सो, वेन यू अलाइन योर सेल्फ विद दैट गोल देन नो वन हैज़ टू टेल यू फॉर यू नो बींग कंसिस्टेंट और डूइंग एक्सरसाइज ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. सिमिलरली हियर, वेन यू थिंक अबाउट यू नो वाई आर यू स्टडिंग एवरी डे, हाउ इज इट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू इन योर फर्दर गोल ऑफ गेटिंग योर ड्रीम ब्रांच एंड ड्रीम कॉलेज. सो यू नो कंसिस्टेंसी ऑटोमेटिकली आ जाएगी. सो एज आई ऑलवेज कॉल इट एज द बर्निंग डिजायर. सो इफ यू हैव द बर्निंग डिजायर टू डू वॉट यू आर डूइंग देन यू नो नोबडी हैज टू टेल यू अबाउट कंसिस्टेंसी, है ना? सो यस, दीज सेशंस विल बी रीवॉचेबल, डू नॉट वरी ऑन दैट फ्रंट. और ये है हमारे बच्चे जो 100% एक्यूरेसी लेके आए हैं आज के क्विज में, अमंग्स द फर्स्ट 500. द नेक्स्ट वाले का आई हैव नॉट गिवन द रिजल्ट्स येट. सो डॉक्टर आर के लता, देन वी हैव सोनू, अक्षत, हर्षा, बे, मैक्स एंड एम आर. एम आर आई सी, यू नो पहले भी जब हम क्विजेस लेते थे, दिस आई यूज टू डू पहले ऑन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप ऑल्सो, एम आर हैज बीन अ वेरी वेरी कंसिस्टेंट परफॉर्मर. येस, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले विद द डिस्कशन. गाइज, कीप दिस टाइम टेबल राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑन द वॉल ऑफ योर स्टडी रूम, टेबल के सामने. टुमोरो एंड डे आफ्टर इज अगेन एनाटमी. I have given you the daily targets. Today is upper limb, lower limb, and embryology. राइट सो वो करना है, बाकी कल का है आपके बाकी टारगेट्स दैट आई हैव गिवन यू. ओके व्हाट इज द प्लान फॉर द डे, राइट व्हाट इज द प्लान फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द डे. सो 5 PM वी आर, सो वी हैव यू नो एक्चुअली 3 सेशंस कमिंग टुडे. 5 PM वी हैव, 8 PM एंड वी हैव 10 PM. अब क्या क्या होने वाला है. 5 PM अ रैपिड रिव्यू ऑफ एनाटॉमी इमेजेस, मिक्स्ड बैग एनाटॉमी इमेजेस, अ वेरी वेरी हाई यील्ड सेशन, रैपिड फायर रिविजन विल बी देयर. ओके और उसके बाद जो हमारा 8 बजे है, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द न्यू सीरीज ऑन अन अकेडमी यूट्यूब चैनल वेयर वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द सीरीज ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंट साइंस इन रेडियोलॉजी. ओके इम्पॉर्टेंट साइंस इन रेडियोलॉजी, आई फाइंड इट वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. यू नो ये साइन को ऐसे क्यों बोलते हैं, वॉट पैथोलॉजी यू सी दिस पर्टिकुलर साइन. सो टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट बिहाइंड इट एंड टू रिमेंबर द वेरियस साइंस, टुडे विल बी न्यूरो रेडियोलॉजी. ओके टुडे विल बी न्यूरो रेडियोलॉजी एंड देन 10 PM we have, because today it is FMG exam, so a general overview of how the exam was today. I'm sure you must be excited ki how crooked or how mild the examiners have become this year. Shayad thoda sa idea aa jaye from this exam ki we've got more time to exam easy aane wala hai ki exam difficult aane wala hai. Hopefully we will get some response from the students ki kaisa tha exam. And I'll be sharing this in the today's 10 p.m. special class on the app. This is on the app. So 5 p.m., 10 p.m. it is on the app and 8 p.m. it is on the YouTube channel. Plus 9 p.m. ka jo humne time decide kiya hai, anatomy aapka quiz hoga at 9 p.m. Okay, it's a live only quiz. You won't be able to attend it later. Theek hai? So ye hai hamara plan. Okay. See, the quizzes which I conduct are free for everyone, guys. You don't have to pay anything for any quizzes. And the sessions also which I am taking are free. So, it's available to everyone. So, make the best of it. Okay, so chalo, start karte hain aaj ka session, the first one. Let me show you the results, guys. Let me show you ki aaj ka accuracy kaisa tha. So, I was telling you that 500 students participated in the quiz. And then I had to generate another link. और उसमें भी कुछ 200-250 बच्चों ने दिया है. द एक्यूरेसी हैज बीन 44%, विच ऑनेस्टली आई एम योर मेंटर वेल विशर, आई एम नॉट वेरी हैप्पी विद. आई एक्सपेक्टेड अ हायर परसेंटेज ऑफ एक्यूरेसी. ओके सो 44% ही एक्यूरेसी रही है ओवरऑल. इन दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट डू वी हैव हियर इज द लास्ट लाइन, क्लिनिकल क्वेश्चन, रीड द लास्ट लाइन. टेंडन ऑफ विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग मसल्स इज मोस्ट लाइकली टू बी इंजर्ड. व्हाट डू वी हैव. 52-year man, right shoulder pain, physical examination, there is subacromial tenderness. The pain is reproduced when the patient is asked to abduct the shoulder against the resistance, when the arm flexed forward by 30 degrees and the thumb pointing downwards. So very, very important when you do this, you know, whatever, I always tell you this tip. Whenever you are reading the questions, if it's a clinical scenario, the best thing is to visualize what is happening. That helps you understand the question very, very well. Okay. So, yes, this one is your empty can test. What is being described here is your empty can test. Guys who have missed the session, मैंने पूरे आपके GIFs के साथ, videos के साथ, orthopedics के test वाला session लिया है. Unacademy app पे है, free class है, recorded देख सकते हो. Please watch that session, extremely important. Empty can test, it is your supraspinatus. So the two important clues here, subacromial tenderness and empty can test positive, it is your supraspinatus. It is your supraspinatus, right? Abhi mujhe ye batao ki a horn blower's test, some new points that we'll be discussing here. What is your horn blower's test for and what is akimbo test for? Have you heard these tests anytime? Ye test ke naam sune hai kabhi? Horn blower's test and akimbo's test. Horn blower's test and akimbo's test. For which muscles do we do the horn blower's test and for which muscle we do the akimbo's test? So I'm seeing your comments here. नहीं सुने हैं, ठीक है कोई बात नहीं. रिमेंबर नाउ, सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर ऑल्सो फॉलोइंग दैट वन नोटबुक एंड यू आर डिवाइडिंग इट इनटू योर सब्जेक्ट्स एंड यू आर एडिंग ऑन द एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अब आपको हॉर्न ब्लोवर्स टेस्ट मिला, ईदर एडेड इन एनाटॉमी और एडेड इन योर ऑर्थोपेडिक्स वाला सेक्शन, सो दैट यू रिमेंबर नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन यू रिवाइज कि ये दिया हुआ है. वेरी गुड रचना इज करेक्ट. जितेश हैज गॉट इट राइट. हॉर्न ब्लोवर्स टेस्ट इज फॉर टीरीज माइनर एंड अकिम्बोस टेस्ट इज फॉर डेल्टॉइड मसल. ओके दैट इज फॉर डेल्टॉइड. अकिम्बोस टेस्ट इज फॉर डेल्टॉइड. सो लुक एट दीज टेस्ट. ये आपका पहले है एम्प्टी कैन टेस्ट, जहां पे आपको दिख रहा है थंब नीचे है एंड अबडक्शन करते हैं सुप्रा स्पाइनेटिस. सो दिस इज योर ऑल्सो जोब टेस्ट. ओके दैट्स योर जोब टेस्ट एम्प्टी कैन टेस्ट. दिस इज वॉट इज योर हॉर्न ब्लोवर्स टेस्ट. जैसे हॉर्न ब्लो करते हैं ना, कार ड्राइव कर रहे हैं हॉर्न ब्लो करते हैं, तो वो वाला होता है. So you ask the patient to abduct 90 degrees, elbow is flexed and you ask the patient to rotate externally. This is your horn blowers test. Okay, this is your horn blowers test which is done for teres minor. Okay, which is done for teres minor. And this is your horn blowers test, also called Patty's test, right? So you abduct the patient's arm to 90 degrees. Flex the elbow to 90 degrees and the patient is asked to laterally rotate the shoulder. A positive test occurs with weakness and or pain. That is your horn blowers test. And this is your Akimbo's test for deltoid. Okay, this is your Akimbo's test for deltoid. So while performing the Akimbo test, the patient is pronating the forearm like you are seeing here, flexing the elbow and the hands are placed on the iliac crest. So this is seen in axillary nerve damage where you have deltoid getting paralyzed. Agar positive test mein, the patient is not able to do like this. So that is your Akimbo test. Cannot do Akimbo. So remember, like Akimbo is a position like this. Let's imagine like it's some dance step. Akimbo dance step. D for dance step. D for deltoid. ऐसे आप किसी को डांस सिखा रहे हो, हाथ रख के ऐसे डांस करो. This is how I teach my daughter as well, the dance steps. उसके बाद सो यू कैन रिमेंबर डी फॉर डी इट इज डेल्टॉइड. ओके दैट्स योर डेल्टॉइड. सो टीरीज माइनर हॉर्न ब्लोवर्स एंड यू हैव योर डेल्टॉइड का अकिम्बो. सो द मेजर क्लूज योर सब एक्रोमियल टेंडरनेस एम्प्टी कैन टेस्ट. प्लीज रिमेंबर सुप्रा स्पाइनेटिस. इट इज सुप्रा स्पाइनेटिस. ऑलराइट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे चलते हैं. लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर एंड लेट मी शो यू हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स गॉट दिस राइट. ओके हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स got this right. Let me show you this. Just give me a moment. Okay, so this is the first question. 44% students got this right. I'm sure next time everyone will get this right. Okay. Next question. Further evaluation is most likely to show which of the following. What are we seeing here? X-ray is showing volar dislocation of the lunate bone. And what are we seeing? There is your swelling tenderness on palpation of the volar wrist joint as well as restricted motion, range of motion due to pain. What will you see on further evaluation? What will you see on further evaluation? So when you have your lunate bone ka volar dislocation, this is something which can affect your median nerve. It can basically lead to your carpal tunnel syndrome. Okay, that can lead to your carpal tunnel. Median nerve ko affect kar sakta hai. So median nerve, we know the first three fingers. So paresthesia over the volar aspect of the first three fingers on wrist flexion. This is basically like also, you know, the Phalen's test jo humne padhi hai wapas ortho ke test mein. So Phalen's test is something like this. Wrist flexion kiya to pain hoga, paresthesia hoga. That is your median nerve. Anesthesia over the dorsal aspect of the first three fingers. On the dorsal aspect, on the extensor aspect, it is your radial nerve. This will be seen in your radial nerve. लूनेट का स्केफॉइड लूनेट होता है. लूनेट का वोलार डिसलोकेशन मतलब आपका यहां का नर्व जा रहा है मीडियन नर्व. टेंडरनेस टू पाल्पेशन ऑफ द एनाटॉमिकल स्नफ बॉक्स. एनाटॉमिकल स्नफ बॉक्स स्केफॉइड फ्रैक्चर में होता है. इट इज इन योर स्केफॉइड फ्रैक्चर, नॉट विथ योर लूनेट. इनवॉलेंटरी फ्लेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ इंटरफेलेंजियल जॉइंट्स when extending all the fingers. That means ये interphalangeal joints का extension नहीं हो रहा है, flexion हो रहा है. What is the action of your lumbrical muscles? Because flexion at the MCP, extension at the interphalangeal joint. यहाँ का lumbricals first to ulnar nerve. So basically your ulnar nerve will be affected. Pale skin color on the volar surface when pressure is applied to the radial artery. So that means जब radial artery को press कर रहे हैं, so ulnar artery आपकी compensate नहीं कर रही है. So that is your ulnar artery is injured. Okay, that's your ulnar artery injured. Like you have hypothenar hammer syndrome, उसमें ulnar artery जाती है. So the only one which is seen with your median nerve is your first option. So the answer is A, paresthesia over the volar aspect of the first three fingers on the wrist flexion. ठीक है, आपका जब median nerve जाता है तो यहाँ पे paresthesia या sensation loss नहीं होता है. Remember that, because it's your palmar cutaneous nerve. It is not the median nerve which goes above the flexor retinaculum. Okay, it goes above the flexor retinaculum. So let us see how many students got this question right. And only 34%. Only 34%. Guys, whenever you get first three fingers, volar aspect ka kuch bhi, always think of that's the median nerve. And lunate ka dislocation, that is your lunate dislocation, that is going to give your, ek minute. Kahan chale gaya hamara pen? I'll drag it here and then we can come here. Okay. So lunate ka volar dislocation, that will compress your median nerve. It will cause your carpal tunnel syndrome. Is that clear with everyone? Okay. Let's go to the This is median nerve. This is not palmar cutaneous. When your fingers are affected, that's your median nerve. Palmar cutaneous, यहाँ पे आपका thinner eminence का sensation loss होगा. ठीक है? चलो. Next one. So you have an MRI of the left lower extremity injury to the long head of biceps and the semitendinosus muscle. Which of the following is most likely origin of the injured muscles? So always read the last two lines first in your lengthy questions. You'll be able to solve the questions faster. And remember that in these quizzes that I am posting every day, the faster you answer, you get a higher score as well. Right. Wapas aapka video stuck ho gaya. Okay now, is it okay now? So always read the last two lines first, guys. You'll be able to solve the questions very fast. So where you have long head of biceps, semitendinosus muscle, these are your hamstring muscles, right? Your hamstring muscles, they originate from your ischial tuberosity, except your short head of biceps femoris. Short head of biceps femoris, it comes from the femur, the linea aspera. So this is ischial tuberosity. When they tell you that physical examination may impaired flexion of the knee and impaired extension of the hip joint. So aapka knee ka flexion impaired hai aur hip ka extension. Knee flexion, hip extension, that is your hamstring muscles. Okay, hamstring peeche ke muscles, knee ka flexion karenge, flexion of the knee and extension of the hip. Now look at your other options. Superior pubic ramus. Which muscle originates from the superior pubic ramus? You have your adductor longus. It is the adductor medial compartment ka muscle. In your hamstring, you have the part of the adductor magnus, not adductor longus. Anterior superior iliac spine. That is your sartorius. Sartorius located anteriorly. It causes your hip flexion. Right, that is not hip extension like in this question. Greater trochanter, which muscle out of the four aapka jo quadriceps hai, usme se kaun sa wala aata hai aapka greater trochanter se?
ग्रेटर ट्रोकेंटर, इफ यू ड्रॉ द फीमर का डायग्राम, आपका ग्रेटर ट्रोकेंटर इधर है लैटरली, तो कौन सा मसल आता है आपका ग्रेटर ट्रोकेंटर से? वास्टस लैटरलिस, द ओरिजिन इज वास्टस लैटरलिस. इंसर्टेड मसल्स आर ग्लूटियस मीडियस मिनिमस पायरिफॉर्मिस, नॉट योर ग्लूटियस मैक्सिमस, राइट. लीनिया एस्पेरा हमने बताया अभी, शॉर्ट हेड ऑफ बाइसेप्स फेमोरिस, that comes from the linea aspera which is located on the posterior side of the femur shaft, posterior side of the femur shaft. Okay, so remember that is your, the answer here is your ischial tuberosity, the hamstring muscles, that is your ischial tuberosity. Very very important, in the lower limb muscles you have your hamstring muscles. All right. ओके सो लुक एट द टेंडेंस हियर. नाउ ये जो आपको एक मसल दिख रहा है विच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द फीमर, विच इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द फीमर, दैट वन इज योर, यू हैव योर शॉर्ट हेड ऑफ बाइसेप्स. ओके सो दैट्स द शॉर्ट हेड ऑफ बाइसेप्स जॉइनिंग विद द लॉन्ग हेड, एंड वेयर इज द बाइसेप्स फीमर इज इंसर्टेड? On the fibula, laterally on the fibula, that's your biceps femoris, right? And rest you have your semitendinosus, semimembranosus muscles included in your hamstring muscles, and this one is your popliteus which has the intra-articular tendon. Frequently asked question, popliteus has intra-articular tendon, okay? And this is your ischial tuberosity here, ischial tuberosity. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे चलते हैं, इसके पहले देखते हैं कितने लोगों का ये क्वेश्चन राइट आया. 58%, सो दैट्स अ गुड नंबर. इट वाज एन इजी क्वेश्चन. योर बाइसेप्स लॉन्ग हेड सेमीटेंडिनोसिस इज इशियल ट्यूबरोसिटी. दिस अगेन वाज अ वेरी वेरी कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन. अगेन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस इन द ऑर्थोपेडिक्स टेस्ट वाला सेशन. प्लीज प्लीज वॉच दैट सेशन, इट विल हेल्प यू इन इंटीग्रेटिंग एनाट एंड ऑर्थो, राइट. So you have that increased laxity of the right knee joint when the knee is flexed and an abducting force is applied. तो आपने knee को flex किया, फिर abducting force apply किया, and you see increased laxity. So basically, to the knee, if these are the knees, you are applying the valgus force outside, मतलब valgus, that is abducting force. That means the inner side वाला ligament is gone. So it is not restricting the knee to go out. आपको जितना बाहर लेके जाना है लेके जाओ. The inhibition is lost. That means because basically here your medial collateral ligament is gone. Okay? That medial collateral ligament is gone. So why not McMurray's test? Because you are applying the abducting force. Abducting force is your valgus stress. In your McMurray's, you do the rotation. Okay, you are, it is your grinding jaise for the meniscus. McMurray's M4M is for meniscus, right? You do the rotation wala. You don't do the abduction. Okay, so this is your medial collateral ligament where you do the valgus stress test. Jo medially present hai, उसके लिए आप lateral वाला stress दो. जो lateral वाला ligament होगा उसके लिए मीडियल वाला स्ट्रेस दो. सो दैट यू सी दैट द इनहिबिशन इज लॉस्ट ऑन द वारस स्ट्रेस टेस्ट. लैटरल कोलैटरल लिगामेंट वारस स्ट्रेस टेस्ट में यू विल सी द इंक्रीज्ड लैक्सिटी. सो द आंसर हियर इज मीडियल कोलैटरल लिगामेंट. व्हेनेवर यू हैव मीडियल कोलैटरल लिगामेंट थिंक ऑफ योर ओडोनॉक्स ट्रायड, द थ्री स्ट्रक्चर्स व्हिच आर अफेक्टेड टुगेदर. जनरली क्या होता है ओडोनॉक्स ट्रायड में? Remember MAM, okay, Odonog MAM. You have medial collateral ligament, you have ACL, and you have medial meniscus. All these three, they generally go together. So the answer here is your medial collateral ligament. Posterior cruciate ligament, you will get your posterior drawer test positive, right? You will get your posterior drawer test. Meniscus, McMurray's test, Epley's grinding test will be positive, okay? Is this clear with everyone? Okay. So this is your on the tibia ka side connecting the femur and the tibia is your medial or the tibial collateral ligament. If that is injured and you do the abduction wala, kyunki yahan pe ligament hai nahi, to ye aaram se ho jayega. So please remember this always ki jo medial side ke ligaments hai, unke liye aap lateral stress test karte ho valgus. जो लैटरल लिगामेंट है उनके लिए आप उल्टा मीडियल वाला स्ट्रेस करते हो, दैट इज द वारस स्ट्रेस टेस्ट. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट ऑलवेज, इट विल हेल्प यू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट वन, अगेन अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन. उसके पहले कितने लोगों का राइट आया, ये 36% गाइस. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर कि मीडियल लिगामेंट के लिए इट इज द वाल्गस स्ट्रेस टेस्ट. ओके, इट्स द वाल्गस स्ट्रेस टेस्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सो यू हैव अ वुमन हु कम्स बिकॉज ऑफ प्रोग्रेसिवली वर्सनिंग लोअर बैक पेन. द पेन इज रेडिएटिंग टू द राइट लेग टू द लैटरल साइड ऑफ द फुट. No trauma, there is no urinary incontinence, there is no fever. MRI पे herniation है L5S1 पे. What is the most likely finding on the physical examination? What do you think is this one? So when you have the disc herniation at L5S1, it is the niche wala nerve which will be affected. That is S1. Okay, that is S1. Now aapka ankle reflex ki root value kya hai? Ankle reflex ki root value kya hai? Remember, 1, 2, buckle my shoe. 3, 4, shut the door. Right, so 1, 2, buckle my shoe was the ankle reflex. 3, 4, shut the door with the knee, that is ankle ke upar knee, that's your knee reflex. 5, 6, pick up the sticks, that is your biceps reflex. And 7, 8, lay them straight wala, 7, 8 wala is your triceps. Okay, so this is C5, 6, this is C7, 8. Is this S3, S4 or is this L3, L4? Knee ka, what is the root value of the knee reflex? इट इज नॉट S3, S4, इट इज आगे जो एंटीरियर हमारे डर्मेटोम्स आते हैं. आपको याद है कि हमारा जो इंग्वाइनल लिगामेंट है, ग्रॉइन में डर्मेटोम होता है ONEL1. फिर आपका थाई में जो आता है ये L1 है, L2 आता है, फिर L3 आता है, राइट. सो दैट इज L3, L4. ओके, द रूट वैल्यू इज L3, L4. So when you have S1 which is gone, so S1-2 ankle reflex, so you will get the ankle reflex which will be weak because this is a lower motor neuron lesion, right? This is not upper motor neuron. Jab upper motor neuron hoga, tab brisk reflexes honge, hai na? So the answer is weak Achilles tendon reflex. Okay, it is weak Achilles tendon reflex. Diminished sensation of the anus and the genitalia. This might be seen in your cauda equina syndrome. But in that you have other urinary complaints, you have bladder, bowel complaints basically, which are not present in this patient. Exaggerated patellar tendon reflex. When you will have exaggerated reflex in your upper motor neuron lesions. Here it is L5S1. L3, L4 ke upar nahi hai. So patellar tendon reflex is gone. Difficulty walking on the heels. That means the patient has foot drop. इसीलिए वो heels पे नहीं चल सक रहा है because foot drop है. So this is basically your foot drop which you get because of the peroneal nerve getting affected, fibula head fracture में. It is like your L3, L4. It is not your L5, S1. Diminished sensation of the anterior lateral thigh. This is L1, this is L2, this is L3. That is seen in your L3. So for dermatomes, guys, for today's target anatomy mein, dermatomes ka session I have taken in the plus course. The links are there. Website check karna ye session ke baad. Website pe links update huye hai. And I, whatever are the important sessions, you know, the sessions that you should watch first in everyday's target, I am highlighting with some color. तो वो वाले सेशंस पहले पहले देख लेना. आउट ऑफ द लॉन्ग लिस्ट, दोज आर द सेशंस दैट यू शुड बी वॉचिंग फर्स्ट. ओके, सो द आंसर हियर इज योर वीक अकेलेस टेंडन रिफ्लेक्स विच इज S1, S2 एंड हियर इट इज L5, S1. इज दिस क्लियर विथ एवरीवन? ओके, इज दिस क्लियर विथ एवरीवन? नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे चलते हैं. 1000 टाइम्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस. So, woman with painful paresthesia in the right foot. उसके पहले ये क्वेश्चन देखूं कितने लोगों का राइट आया था. 32%. So, guys, I hope you'll make it right the next time. Remember, S1, S2 is your Achilles tendon reflex. That is your ankle reflex. Okay? So now you have examination shows decreased sensation in the first interdigital space, that is the first web space, and there is hallux valgus. Hallux valgus matlab bahar ki taraf aapka deformity hai. This patient's paresthesia is most likely by the compression of your deep peroneal nerve. Many times we have discussed this. In the foot, it is your deep peroneal nerve. In the hand, the first web space dorsum, that is your radial nerve. Okay, that's your radial nerve. Rest of the foot, dorsum of the foot, lateral aspect of the foot, that is your superficial peroneal nerve. But the first web space, that is your deep peroneal nerve. Tibial nerve is your nerve of the posterior compartment. So, sole mein se sensation jayega. Plantar nerves aayegi aapke tibial nerve se, wahan aayega. Sural nerve and saphenous nerve. Sural nerve is the lateral aspect of the foot and saphenous nerve is from the medial malleolus, ankle medially. That is your saphenous nerve. Okay. So remember, saphenous nerve medially, sural nerve is laterally, and this one is your deep peroneal nerve. So very, very important first web space here. It is your deep peroneal. Lateral aspect of foot is your sural nerve. And the rest of the foot is your superficial peroneal nerve. Okay, that's your superficial peroneal nerve. Very, very important. Okay, please remember this. Okay, I think this is the last question now. Iske pehle dekhte hain ye question kitne logo ka right aaya. Okay, so I think this is the easiest question here. 60% got it right. First web space is your deep peroneal nerve. Please remember that. First web space is your deep peroneal nerve. Okay. So this was a question on embryology. In today's target, you have embryology as well. So the question is, in a normal fetus, the T2 signal is most likely to be highest in which of the following vessels? So you have the investigator studying your MRI mein fetal blood oxygen level ke hisab se kya hota hai. And it was seen that the magnetic resonance transverse relaxation time, that is T2, is inversely related to the concentration of deoxyhemoglobin. That means when you have high concentration of deoxy, it produces a low signal intensity on T2. So that means when you have deoxygenated hemoglobin, that gives your T2 dark appearance. Low signal intensity means T2 dark. When it is oxyhemoglobin, that means it will be T2 bright. And the question is, which of the following will show the highest T2 signal? Which of the following vessels? That means, which of the following vessels will have maximum oxygenated blood hemoglobin in the fetus? Okay, right? This is in the fetus. So, let us quickly see the fetal circulation mein kya hota hai. So, from the placenta, right, in the fetus, the oxygenation of blood is occurring in the placenta. That is functioning like the lungs. Lungs function nahi karte hain. Lungs will mature later on after the birth. Usme air wagera jayega, fir wo expand honge. Till then, the function is done by the placenta. So you have the umbilical vein which carries the blood, oxygenated blood to the fetus, umbilical vein to the fetus. Then the umbilical vein blood through the ductus venosus, okay, through the ductus venosus, it is combining with the deoxygenated blood from the IVC. Phir wahan se wo ja raha hai right side of heart mein. From the right side of heart going to the pulmonary artery, it does not go to the lungs. Okay, lungs mein nahi ja raha hai. Direct from the pulmonary artery, it gets to the aorta. So there's a communication between your pulmonary circulation and the systemic circulation by the ductus arteriosus. Okay, by the ductus arteriosus. तो वो डायरेक्ट एओटा में जाके फिर पूरे फीटर्स के बॉडी को सप्लाई करेगा. सो बेसिकली इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू द लंग्स. लंग्स में नहीं जाता है आपका मेजर ब्लड. ओके, सो दिस इज आफ्टर बर्थ. देन व्हाट हैपेंस, योर डक्टस आर्टेरियोसस क्लोजेस क्योंकि नाउ द ब्लड विल गो टू द लंग्स, राइट? सो यू हैव डक्टस आर्टेरियोसस विच फॉर्म्स योर लिगामेंटम आर्टेरियोसम. डक्टस वेनोसस फॉर्म्स योर लिगामेंटम वेनोसम, राइट? दैट फॉर्म्स योर लिगामेंटम वेनोसम. Your umbilical arteries, okay, your umbilical arteries, they become your medial umbilical ligament, right? They become your medial umbilical ligament. Is that clear with everyone? Medial umbilical ligament banta hai aur aapka superior vesical artery banta hai. है ना. व्हाट फॉर्म्स द लिगामेंटम टीरीज, व्हाट फॉर्म्स द लिगामेंटम टीरीज, प्लीज सी हियर, योर ऑब्लिटरेटेड लेफ्ट अम्बिलिकल वेन. ओके, योर ऑब्लिटरेटेड लेफ्ट अम्बिलिकल वेन, this one, the umbilical vein is what forms your ligamentum teres, a very very important question, right? Medial umbilical ligament is your umbilical artery, right? That is your umbilical artery. Or umbilical artery basically kahan se aa rahi hai? Fetus mein. It is your internal iliac artery, right? You have your internal iliac arteries jahan se aapki aa rahi hai umbilical arteries, and that portion of the umbilical artery, the proximal one, it forms your superior vesical artery as well, right? It forms your superior vesical artery. So the points to be remembered here, that ligamentum arteriosum is ductus arteriosus, ligamentum venosum is your ductus venosus, which is basically connecting your umbilical vein to the IVC, and that is how the blood goes to the right side of the heart, and from the pulmonary artery, ductus arteriosus, it goes to the aorta. What does your umbilical artery form? That forms your median umbilical ligament. Median, yeah, medial. Remember, it is medial umbilical, not median. Median is uracus. And what forms your ligamentum teres? The umbilical vein. Ek hi umbilical vein hoti hai, umbilical cord mein. Do artery hoti hai, ek vein hoti hai. It is the left umbilical vein which is there. The right is already gone, right? So it is the left umbilical vein which forms the ligamentum teres. Okay, that forms the ligamentum teres. So out of all of these pulmonary veins, no, umbilical arteries going from the fetus to the placenta, they carry deoxygenated blood. Ductus venosus, what is ductus venosus? Communicating your umbilical vein, that has your oxygenated blood, right? That has your oxygenated blood. So ductus venosus is the one which will have the highest signal on T2 MRI. Let us see how many students got this right. That's a great number. 43% got this right. So guys, this was an example of how the questions, simple questions, ki which of these carries oxygenated blood, ghuma fira ke pooch lenge, and it will seem like a difficult question. But actually, it's not a difficult question. Okay. So fetal circulation, the embryological remnants is something which is an important topic. Again, from the plus course, please watch that embryologica session as well. आपका target, आज का target आपका है embryology. वो session पहले देख लेना. Majority of the embryology will be done. We have all the cheat codes, mnemonics that we have discussed there. एक session है embryology MCQs का. वो वाला भी देख लेना. For those who do not have the plus subscription, there is free session. एक KBMD का quiz हुआ था embryology का. वो देख लेना. And in some other sessions also, I have discussed a part of embryology. So, ye sab sessions aap dekh lena to cover your embryology in a very, very easy way. Okay. So, I think, yes, that was the last question for the day, guys. So, this was the quiz of 7 questions. And I hope all of you have got to learn out of these questions. Quickly revise kar lete hain with the flashcards so that everything is consolidated. Whatever we have learned. Kahan hai flashcards? Okay. So this was the first question that we had here. 1 minute. So this was the first question that we had, and it said about your right subacromial tenderness, and it was MT can test, thumb pointing downwards, that is supraspinatus muscle, right? That is supraspinatus. Then you have your next one, where what did we see? Keep severe pain hai right wrist mein, volar wrist joint pe swelling tenderness hai. और क्या दिया हुआ था इसमें? Lunate bone का volar dislocation है. This is your median nerve gone. So first 3 fingers gone. So there will be your paresthesia of the volar aspect of the first 3 fingers on the wrist flexion. That is your Phalen's test basically. Median nerve carpal tunnel syndrome. Next one we had was Biceps femoris and semitendinosus origin from where? Hamstring muscles, ischial tuberosity, except your short head of femoris from the femur. So ischial tuberosity. Next one, increased laxity of the right knee joint when you have abducting force. Abducting force matlab valgus, yani andar wala aapka ligament gaya hai. Medial collateral ligament. Then we have your L5-S1 disc herniation. S1, S2, your ankle reflex will be gone. So there will be weak ankle tendon reflex, right? Weak Achilles tendon reflex. Then you have your decreased sensation in the first space of the foot, dorsum, that is your deep peroneal nerve. Okay, that's your deep peroneal nerve. And the next one we had, T2 signal, kis mein sabse zyada hoga? That is the maximum oxygenated blood, that is your ductus venosus. Okay, that's your ductus venosus, not the IVC. IVC carries your deoxygenated blood. It is the umbilical vein, the channel communicating umbilical vein with IVC, that is your ductus venosus. Okay, IVC nahi. IVC to aapka deoxygenated hai, it is ductus venosus. Okay, So I don't think IVC will have the highest concentration. IVC to aapka fetus ki body se blood leke ja raha hai. Okay, so guys, my phone has also conked off now. I won't be able to see your comments. Aapke dikhenge nahi, aapke comments mujhe sirf yahan dikhenge. Theek hai. So I will still confirm about your IVC thing, and according to me, it should not be the IVC, right? If it is not superior vena cava, it should not be inferior vena cava as well. Inferior vena cava at least will have more oxygen content as compared to SVC because it is receiving the blood from the ductus venosus. So if you do not have ductus venosus in the option, then go for IVC, otherwise go for ductus venosus. Ductus venosus ke baad mein aapka umbilical vein hai option mein. So that will be the most correct ones. So most correct umbilical, then your ductus venosus, and then your IVC. Okay, then your IVC. This is how the sequence of the answer should be. Alright guys. So let's meet at 5 PM with a rapid revision of anatomy images. It's gonna be mixed bag images in anatomy. I'll see you at 5 PM. And then at 8 PM, important science in neuroradiology today. And then at 10 PM, the FMG, the reaction of the students, how was the paper, and some pep talk. If you have any queries or preparation queries, you can get on board in the today's session. All right. So thank you so much for joining.